I'm at the i360, where a very positive report has been released about the social and economic impact of the i360 on our city. I'm going to talk to Julia Barfield and to Ian Hart. She's the chair and architect of the i360, and he is the chief operating officer of the British Airways i360. Join me, Yael Breuer, for Latest TV.
We also pride ourselves on working with and showcasing products and work of many Brighton and Hove artists and suppliers. In fact, 46% of all our retail suppliers are based in Sussex. During the construction phase, most of the shingle extracted from the foundations went to Shoreham to be returned to the beach, helping to reverse longshore drift. And our current provider, Good Energy, provides 100% clean energy from renewable sources. More than 50% of the energy needed to power the pod upwards is captured again on its descent. We use low energy LED across the site. Waste is disposed of responsibly, with no waste going to landfill. We've also given more than 46,000 free tickets to Brighton and Hove State Schools. This equates to £320,000 of social value. We have produced curriculum material to support Key Stage 1 and 2. Now, this has led to us winning a number of awards. In fact, it's over 20 now in total. And these are both national and local awards in recognition of its design, engineering, construction, and contribution to the local visitor economy. And our PR reach nationally and internationally has been estimated at around 2.5 billion, that's billion, since we opened in August 2016. In the 3 years since opening, Brighton i360 have already made a significant contribution to Brighton and Hove in economic, social and educational terms. Nearly £30 million annual contribution to the local economy. So that's a total of nearly £90 million to the local economy since opening. And the total value of the benefit will be £640 million by 2041. We also had a major impact on employment. Most jobs are created on site are filled by people who live within the Brighton and Hove area. Additional jobs created due to Brighton i360 totals 447.
We are a unique attraction. We take our social and economic responsibilities very seriously. We've been a catalyst for regeneration in the area, and we've won lots of awards, and we try and be a responsible business. So, I mean, today is really looking at the bigger picture and telling a good news story. So thank you very much.
Ian Hart, you gave a very positive talk earlier on, which sounded so encouraging for the i360 and for the city. Do you want to give us a summary of what you were talking about?
Yeah, I suppose what today is all about is the launch of our social and economic impact report, which has been done by independent consultants to show the effect and the impact that we have on the city. When this whole project was conceived and designed and constructed, we always believed we were going to have a positive impact. The last 3 years whilst we've been operating, we believed we were giving that positive impact, but now we know we absolutely are. And the key figures that have come out of this report is that the value that we give to the city on an annual basis is just under £30 million a year.
Which is a lot of money.
It's a lot of money, and probably more than we were expecting, which means over the 3 years that we've been operating so far, that's just under £90 million that we've contributed to the local economy and to the local community.
The local community has benefited in many ways, including you work with charities, local businesses, you're very sustainable, many jobs have been created. What are your plans for the future?
Well, I think you've just summarised it extremely well. It's all of those things, and what we want to do is continue to do that, because I think what's really important to us is that the way we operate this business and this attraction is that we do it in a responsible way, that we're responsible and that we're supportive and contributing to the local community, to the local economy, and to do it in a sustainable, environmentally friendly way. So we're pushing all the time, whatever we're doing, however we're doing it, we want to do it better.
I'm very excited about this. I mean, this is amazing. The views, the atmosphere is great. One of the criticisms about the i360 is that people who may have been on it once might say, you know, been there, done that. How would you encourage people to come back?
Well, this is talking to people like you, I suppose, because you've just informed me this is the first time you've been up. So the thing is, every time you come up here, and I obviously come up here quite regularly, is that it is different. You see different things. You see different distances. The weather's different. The light's different. And therefore, it is a different experience every single time. And one of the times, if you've been during the day, that's great. But one of the times, if you haven't done it already, that you really need to come up here is to see the sunset. It is glorious to be up here and see the sun setting on a beautiful evening.
Oh, that sounds amazing. And I'm going to look for my house if I can.
We see so far that way out towards Beachy Head. Even today is a lovely day, and we can actually see out as far as the Isle of Wight. And of course you can see all over the city, the whole thing, and out into the national park.
Julia, congratulations on a very good report.
Yes.
This morning. And you said earlier that it was actually better than you expected.
You know, we wanted to get independent experts because, I mean, you know, we've seen the economic benefits that this has brought, particularly to the seafront. But then we wanted to get someone independent, you know, who's expert in this, to actually verify that and actually find out what the numbers are. There's no question that we won't be paying all the money back within the same time. But, you know, we wanted to know what the bigger picture was.
Bigger picture is not just about money, isn't it? It's about education. It's about, you know, helping Brighton to become even a more leading city.
Yes.
In terms of tourism, sustainability, environment.
Yeah.
Do you want to tell me a little bit about that?
I mean, the project was always about more than just, you know, visitor numbers. It was always about meant to be about regeneration and having a positive impact on Brighton. We always also took a responsible attitude to the environment, to our staff, and you know, tried to include as many people from Brighton in the kind of overall sphere of the project. You know, we got lots of local artists to contribute to some of the offerings in the shop. You know, we have local champagne, local beer.
And on a personal note, it's been quite a journey for you. You designed the i360 with your late husband David.
Yes.
You also designed the London Eye.
Yes.
With
yes.
him.
Yes.
How different and how similar are the two projects, and how do you personally feel about the journey?
Well, I mean, the London Eye obviously was very exciting. You know, we started that in 1993. It opened in 2000, and that was a 7-year journey. This actually took longer. You know, after the success of the London Eye, many people kind of approached us and said, can we have one of those, please? And we realised that actually there's very few cities that can actually support a project of that scale. And so, and it was mainly David. I can't take credit for it. He came up with the idea of the i360 as being a method of delivering the same experience of the London Eye, of this slowly unfolding view of a city from a great height, but designed a different method of delivering that that was more economic and could be afforded by more places. When he came down to the city in 2005, of course, you know, the fire had consumed the West Pier 2 years earlier, and you know, it was a kind of marriage made in heaven, really, with the project and the West Pier site as being a vertical pier.
Right.
You know, so delivering a very similar type of experience, although obviously not outdoors, but actually in a more kind of 21st century way. Obviously, sad that he's not here to see this.
Very
in particular.
Sad. He would have been very proud.
Yes.
And from a personal journey to a proper journey, you had a journey this morning from London to Brighton. You saw the sunrise. What do you feel about the city of Brighton?
Well, I love it. I love Brighton. You know, it. You know, the kind of values that it expresses. You know, it's a very sustainable city, and I think it's very ambitious in terms of the climate emergency.
Ian Hart, we're going down now after having viewed these amazing views. Tell me a little bit about your vision for the future.
Well, what we're very keen to do is to continue to do what we've already started to do. We want more people to actually understand who we are and what we can provide. The great views across the city, across the coastline, across the national park. And whenever you come up here, it's a different experience. You see different things, the light's different, and therefore we want to continue to make sure we're giving our customers the best possible experience, whilst also making sure that we work closely with the city in terms of making sure that the whole visitor economy is as positive as possible for Brighton and Hove City.
And you're targeting local visitors as well as national and international visitors?
We're targeting the whole world. In reality, we welcome absolutely everybody. We do have international tourists coming. We have a strong support from residents and resident membership within the city, and we encourage that. And also, probably one of our largest areas is generally the southeast area and south of London, and that's where a lot of our marketing activity is targeted. When they do come, the evidence that we've got from people like TripAdvisor and Google and Visit England is that they do enjoy the experience, and we get very high ratings on all those platforms. You can hire the pod out for a half hour flight or more at a commercial rate. We also do a really great product, which is Sky Dining, whereby you can actually dine in the pod on a three course meal at night with the lights on, and you see the city at night. Absolutely fantastic. There are various other events which we hold in the pod, as well as our event space downstairs.
So the involvement with the city has been very important and practically very detailed as well. It's not just an attraction for Brighton, is it? You've contributed to the local economy, but also community-wise, charities, businesses, schools, education, sustainability, environment.
Yes.
It's very impressive. Has it all been thought of while the establishment of the attraction?
Yeah, all of that stuff is fundamental to who we are. It was there at the conception of what we are, who we are, and it's fundamental to the way we operate. You know, we believe very much in, wherever possible, we're using local suppliers, local food. 46% of all our products in the shop are sourced from Sussex, the county itself. We encourage local artists, local producers, we give people their first chance at actually coming into retail here. Everything we do, we try and do with that local aspect in mind, because we want to be as environmentally friendly, as sustainable and as supportive of the local community as we possibly can be.
And this could be a model for the rest of the world, really. I mean, other cities
that's
could
an
come
ambition.
And...
but if it could be, even in a small way, then that would be great. Because, as I say, you know, it is doing our business in a responsible way is fundamental to the conception and the operation. And therefore, this isn't a bolt-on, this isn't an add-on, it's not a gimmick, it's fundamental to the way we operate. And I think if more businesses could do that and consider every aspect of their business, looking after the local community, looking after the environment, it has to be a good thing.
Very impressive. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you for coming.